Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Life Science with KMD. Today I am going to explain about floral biology. Floral biology is an area of ecological research that studies the evolutionary factors that have been molded the structure, behavior and physiological aspects involving in the flowering of a plant. The field is broad and interdisciplinary and involved research requiring experts from multiple disciplines that can include botany, ecology, biochemistry, entomology and a range of analytical techniques. A slight narrow area of research within floral biology is sometimes termed as pollination biology or anthology. Flowers are structures that are produced by angiosperm and their evolution is intricately associated with their pollinator, particularly insects. Flowers are costly structures that target the pollinator by offering them rewards so as to enhance the cross-pollination. The evolution of the size of flower, their structure and the nature of reward and the way these signals are transmitted and perceived by the potential pollinator are typically examined in terms of the cost incurred and the benefit and the benefits occurred. So the timing of flowering, the duration of flowering and the mode by which they cease the function once their role is fulfilled are all areas of research within the field of floral biology. Pistil is an integrated organ comprising stigma, style and ovary. Stigma is covered with unicellular or multicellular papillae, which are modified epidermal cells. The surface of stigma may be wet or dry, meaning copious or sparse secretion respectively. This secretion contains lipid, carbohydrate, protein and water, and this is the site of pollen recognition, hydration and germination. Pre-pollination secretion occur in all species and in a minority there is an additional secretion in response to pollination. Style structure vary but most conform to one of the three pattern: open style when a central canal filled with mucilage are characteristics of many cotyledons, monocotyledons and of some dicotyledons such as citrus. Closed style with a solid transmitting tissue and no canal predominates in dicotyledons and in some monocotyledons such as grasses. Ovary contain one or more ovules with integument which form the micropyle, the surrounding nucellus and embryo sac. After meiosis, the haploid egg cell along with two synergid cells and a central canal contain two polar nuclei and three antipodal cells is produced by mitosis during embryo sac formation. A normal mature embryo sac therefore contain 7 cells and 8 haploid nuclei. Overall, secretory cells of the stigma, style, ovary provide an extracellular medium for pollen tube attraction, growth and nutrition. Semi-closed style are an intermediate condition found in avocado and in some eucalyptus. Transmitting tissue is composed of longitudinal files of elongated cells which produce an extracellular secretion through which the pollen tube grows. Double fertilization is unique to angiosperms and refer to the fact that both sperm nuclei fertilize nuclei within the embryo sac. After germinating on the stigma, pollen tube grows between the transmitting tissue cells of the style and on reaching the ovary continue through the micropyle and nucleus, entering the embryo sac via one of the synergids. The pore formation in the pollen tube wall, through which a small amount of cytoplasm is released along with the two sperm nuclei. One migrate to the egg cell and fuse with the egg nucleus to form diploid zygote, which develop into embryo. The other migrate to the central canal and there fuse with the two polar nuclei to form a triploid endosperm, which act as a food source for the developing embryo. Pollen is produced within the anther with pollen grain varying from size 3.5 up to 300 micrometer in diameter, even up to 3 millimeter long, with filamentous pollen of aquatic angiosperm such as Zostera. In general, small pollen grains are wind dispersed and large grains are animal dispersed, and their shape may spherical or elongated, oval or triangular or tetrahedral. At maturity, pollen grains are dehydrated propagules. Most pollen occur as single grains, but some aggregate to composite structure such as a polyads of acacia with 4, 8, 16, 32 or 64 genetically identical grains, and the pollinia of orchid consisting of hundreds of thousands of grains. Highly sculptured pollen surface are characteristics of animal dispersal, whereas wind dispersed species have smooth grains. Pollen surface can be sticky, which cause grain to clump, and in some species whisin thread hold the grain together. These kind of pollens are generally animal dispersed, whereas the grains with a dry surface are mostly wind dispersed. Cell number varies at the anther adhesion. 2/3 of angiosperm release bicellular pollen grain with a vegetative cell containing controlled tube growth and metabolism, and a generative cell which divide after pollen germination into two sperm cells. The other third release tricellular pollen grain with vegetative cell and a two sperm as generative cell divides before pollen dispersal and germination. Pollen coat contain lipid, protein, carbohydrate and pigment. In insect pollinated species, it is brightly colored. It function as a pollinator, attraction, adhesion to the pollen pollinator bodies and to other grains, and recognition of a compatible stigma. Pollen wall exine pattern is a characteristic of these species. It contain a sporopollenin, a highly resistant polymerized colored carotenoid, and has micropores which contain a material called pollen kite. Remarkable durability of exine has allowed semi-fossilized pollen coat to survive in many Asian sediments. The paleobotanist can identify source plant type of from the pollen shape and sculpture. This enabled construction of vegetation histories over millions of years, often at the site where few other plant remain persist. Exine is absent in some species, whereas pollen wall intine is unpatterned and is present in all pollen types. Intine consists of polysaccharide and contain tubules filled with proteins and enzymes. Over the germination aperture, which vary in number with species. The exine is thin, absent or present as a cap, whereas the intine is thicker and more complex in structure. Pollen in anther are surrounded by tapetum. The tapetum provide nutrition for the development of developing microspore, contributes to pollen wall formation and deposit protein and pollen coats substance into the exine pore. We will see later how these molecule can influence reproductive outcome. The tapetum degenerates later in the pollen development prior to anther dehiscence. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a